In this animation, we'll be examining the steps required to perform nodal analysis on a linear DC network. We are going to use nodal analysis to calculate the currents and voltages for the resistors in this network. We'll begin by outlining the 8 steps required for performing a nodal analysis. The first step in the process is to identify and label all nodes in the circuit. Next, we select and label a reference node. In the third step of the process, we identify all independent nodes in the circuit. We then arbitrarily assign current directions for all currents entering or leaving the independent nodes in the network. Next, we create the Kirchhoff current law equation for the currents entering or leaving each independent node. We then use Ohm's law to express each independent node current in terms of the selected current direction. In step 6, we express the KCL equations for the independent nodes using their Ohm's law representations. We then move on to solve for the unknown independent node voltages using the equations obtained from step 6. Lastly, we use the calculated independent node voltages, along with the Ohm's law representation of the currents for the independent nodes, to solve for voltages and currents throughout the network. This simple linear DC network consists of 2 voltage sources and 3 resistors. We are provided with the source voltage values as well as the ohmic values of the 3 resistors in the network. We begin our analysis with step 1 of the process. We have identified 4 nodes for this network and labeled them node A, node B, node C, and node D. Moving on to the second step, we have selected node D as the reference node for this network. All voltages in the network will be calculated with respect to this reference node. In the third step of the process, we determine if each of the remaining nodes is dependent or independent with respect to this chosen reference node. The voltage at node A is dependent upon the value of the E1 source. Node A is therefore a dependent node. Similarly, the voltage at node C is dependent upon the value of the E2 source. This means that C is also a dependent node. The voltage at node B is not dependent upon the value of any fixed voltage element and cannot therefore be known immediately. Node B therefore is considered to be an independent node. We complete the third step by assigning arbitrary current directions for the current entering and current leaving node B. To begin the fourth step of the process, we write the KCL equation for node B. Kirchhoff's current law states that the current entering a node must equal the current leaving the node. Therefore, the I1 current entering node B must be equal to the sum of the I2 and I3 currents which are leaving node B. In step 5, we redefine the node B currents using Ohm's law. We will begin with the I3 current which flows through resistor R3. The I3 current direction that we selected will determine how the equation is constructed. In order for current to flow in our selected current direction, VREF must be at a higher potential than VB. For the resulting I3 current to be positive if flowing in this direction, we have to take the negative end away from the positive end, leaving a positive quantity to be divided by the resistance value. This results in an Ohm's law representation for the I3 current of VREF minus VB divided by R3. Next, we will create the Ohm's law representation for the current I1. In order for current to flow in our selected current direction, VB must be at a higher potential than VREF. Following our previous convention, this gives us a starting point of VB minus VREF, all divided by the value of R1. However, we must also consider the effects of the E1 voltage source on this equation. We must either add or subtract the value of E1 over R1 to our starting point equation. To determine if the source effects are added or subtracted, we simply look at the sign of the terminal into which our selected current direction flows. As our selected current direction enters the negative terminal of the source, we subtract E1 over R1 from our starting point equation. Lastly, we move on to create the Ohm's law representation for the I2 current. In order for current to flow in our selected current direction this time, Vref must be at a higher potential than Vb. This provides us with a starting point for our I2 equation of Vref minus Vb all being divided by the value of R2. This time, however, our selected current direction enters the positive terminal of source E2. This results in the value of E2 over R2 being added to the equation for the I2 current. Now that we have the Ohm's law equations for the currents in the circuit, we move on to step 6 of the process. In this step, we'll express the KCL equation for the independent node, node B, using its Ohm's law representation for currents. We begin by replacing the I1 value with its equivalent V over R representation. Similarly, we replace the I2 value in the KCL node B equation with its Ohm's law representation. Lastly, we replace the I3 value with its Ohm's law equivalent to complete the modified KCL equation. In step 7, we solve for the unknown independent node voltage, VB, using the equations obtained from step 6. We begin by substituting in our known voltages and resistance values in the equation. Note that we have assigned 0 volts to Vref in the equation. At this point, we desire to clear the fractions in the KCL equation, so we find the lowest common multiple for the denominators 3, 6, and 9. This value turns out to be 18. We therefore multiply both sides of the equation by 18, clearing the fractions. We proceed on to solve for the value of VB and end up with a final result of 13.091 volts. In our final step of the process, we will use the calculated independent node voltage along with the Ohm's law representation and the currents for the independent node to solve for voltages and currents throughout the network. Substituting our known and calculated values, we arrive at an I1 current of 0.364 amperes, an I2 current of 1.818 amperes, and finally an I3 current of negative 1.454 amperes. As a quick check of our solutions, we can substitute these calculated current values into our original KCL node B equation to confirm our results. It is important to note that our resulting value for the I3 current was negative. This means that the I3 current actually flows opposite to the direction that we assumed at the start of our analysis. Finally, we can use the current values and directions to calculate the polarity and voltage drops across the resistors in the network. We can now mark the polarity of the resistors according to our confirmed current directions, as shown here. We can then use Ohm's law to calculate the voltage drop across each resistor using the calculated currents and the known resistance values. The voltage drop across R1 is 1.091 volts. Across R2 we have 10.909 volts. And lastly, across R3 we have 13.091 volts. As can be seen, nodal analysis is a powerful tool that can be used to determine voltages and currents in a linear DC network. Take a moment and review the 8 general steps required for performing a nodal analysis.